Hello, dear friends. Our journey continues. Currently, we're in Malipo County and on our way to a village where wild tea trees are growing. Yesterday, we wanted to get a bit closer to the place, but we were very tired and decided to stop in a nearby village in a hotel. As you can see, it's early in the morning. Mist covers the mountain tops. We noticed that the road construction on a nearby mountain is done manually for the most part, because they have only one excavator, so they have to throw off huge boulders by hand. They're working near the road, so we had to be careful of falling rocks. It's cold out here, even colder than in Guangxi. We need to spend 3 more hours on the road, because it's a long way. Although it's only 70 kilometers from here. But to travel these 70 kilometers, it takes 3 hours. Because of serpentine mountain roads. This place is beautiful. It's different from other Yunnan districts. Wenshan region is very distinctive. We're approaching the village. 15 kilometers left. Currently, we're traveling through a protected area of the forest, which is a nature reserve. The village is located inside this nature reserve, so it should be quite nice there. Finally, we arrived in a small village, but no one can understand us here. They even can't understand my driver at all. Minority nationalities live here. They can understand commonplace things, like One Piece. So they can't understand what we're trying to say. We try to ask if they know a place to eat, but unfortunately, they can't understand us. We finally had lunch. We managed to find a small cafe. I noticed that there's a lot of political propaganda in the village. In fact, there's a lot of propaganda all over China. Until recently, there wasn't that much. But in the last 3 years, there's a lot more. This one caught my attention. It says, "We will defeat the triad." I haven't seen this one before. It drew my attention because the owner of the cafe was missing one finger. As far as I know, this is a type of punishment in triads for those who've shown themselves badly in the community. Finally, we got to the farmer. The owner of the cafe introduced us to him. We wouldn't get here by ourselves because he lives on a farm. He makes gu shu cha. Here we have danju cha, which means tea from a single tree. There are several bags of it. Natural, fresh sheng. Each type of tea comes from one tree. That's why it's called danju. These sheng are top quality, because the taste is not mixed, although they come from one tree. The only downside of this tea is that it's very limited. Here we only have 5 bags of it, because there are a few specific tea trees. Let's try it out. The farmer is quite young. He has 2 children. This house is very clean. Everything is neat. But it's like this only on the first floor, because it's being renovated on the second floor. We're going to taste the tea right now. True gushu aroma. You won't confuse its aroma with anything else. Exactly what I needed. The aroma reminds me of Yongdei tea, which we found in a distant village, Chu Gushu. Its price is similar to Danzhou. Here we have the second type. The first one's more fragrant than the second. We also have a cheap tea. But we'll start with the second one. Let's try it out. Interesting aroma. The scent of the dry leaf wasn't promising. While the water was boiling, I forgot to compare. Let's see how it will stand up. Let's try the third one. I think it should be really good. The aroma is sweet. My tableware came in handy. I keep forgetting that I can use it. We're good now. Let's put more of it. Wow, the aroma is closer to the first one. It's possible that the second tea was poorly roasted. Wow, this one is really good. It was made on April 6th. This tea comes from two trees, and that one's from a single tree. The one we didn't like comes from another place. Let's try the last one. It smells really nice. They say that the trees are enormous in girth. Let's see if we'll buy some of it. And then we'll have a super tea. Shengs here have a very powerful, strong taste. They remind me of Yongdei tea. What's interesting is that they usually cultivate only one or two Danzhou trees. Let's try another one. He's saying that the second Danzhou that we didn't like was made from bad raw materials, that he asked other people to pick. I got a little sick on the way, but these teas should help me get better. I'm already feeling better. The micronutrients are helping. It's the fourth gushu for today. Let's try the simplest everyday tea. The tea we're trying now also comes from old trees, and it's cheaper. It comes from old pruned trees, so the taste is different. The trees are 150 to 300 years old, but they're pruned. The Danzhou we're drinking right now comes from a 600-year-old tree. The difference between them is substantial, because the older tree is much more unique. The aroma is very pleasant. He told us that his relative was learning roasting for 5 years. Then he came here and taught him. This year he produced his first tea. The tea is good. It means that this year it's dryish, so the tea did not go so well. It's sheng by its aroma and looks, but it has a light green tea flavor, with a very pleasant, delightful aftertaste. He also has four more bags of different sheng. Let's try all of them. He says that they're all different, so we'll try them all together and taste each separately. He makes 5 to 7 kilograms of tea every day. We're going to try 3 shengs. There are a lot of guests. Good thing that they don't smoke indoors. The owner is here, and 5 other people as well. You can hear a lot of noise, but compared to the street, it's not so bad. The only thing that irritates me most in China is smoking. I need to get used to it, but it's annoying when you're drinking tea. But when you sit there, with a very big row of teas, and try to somehow compare the flavor, it makes it more difficult to judge the aroma. The third one has an unusual fragrance. We realize that every tea is different. The one I like the most is the first. It has the best aroma, but the taste is similar to others. I don't think we'll take these two, just the first one. The first taste doesn't tell us that it's not fried. I remember 8 years ago when we were in Jinggu. We were frying tea in a pan, and we made a very strong tea. But it's still different from what they have here. The farmer said that they roast tea and then drink it on the spot. You basically fry sheng in a pan. It's important not to burn it, and it will be delicious. For them, it tastes the same, because they usually fry it in a pan. And we don't drink raw tea. The last tea we're trying is the red tea, Gushu Hongcha. The aroma is very nice. We've done the main thing, which is to buy an excellent tea. Danzhou Cha, from one single tree, and Gushu, from ancient prune trees. We persuaded the farmer to come with us and to show us the way to the main village, because it's a tricky mountain road. We're going to the place where the trees grow. I hope we'll find this place. And we get to see the same tree, a part of which we bought today. And here we are, near the very tree which was used to make the tea we just bought. Good farmers are honest, because the quality of the tea can be easily checked. You just show up in the next harvest, and if the tea tastes different, it means that they tricked you. They don't prune this tree at all, and as we can see here, it allows the branches to grow very long, and the breakthrough of naturalness is felt as no one can touch it. The minus of this method is the small volume of raw material harvested. But the plus is that the tree is completely natural, and the tea has a much better taste, and it's a more natural product. I have a wonderful tradition of climbing tea trees. I usually harvest tea at the same time. But it seems like it was harvested already. So let's climb. This tree is easier to climb than ones in Guangxi. Guangxi trees have a lot of branches, but this one has ladders, which shows that the tea from this tree has been harvested for a very long time. The job of a tea picker is very difficult. Firstly, you need to be very careful that you don't fall down. And secondly, the most important thing, you need to reach the right place. I won't climb to the top. The branches are quite fragile, so that I don't break any branches. It's necessary to take care of the trees well. So yeah, this is how tea pickers do their job. They also gather one type of tea from different trees. We bought the tea from the tree I'm on right now. I always try to climb tea trees that we bought the tea from, if I can. But it's often not allowed in more popular places, like Bulangshan, Nano, because trees there are mostly 1,000 years old. Now all the tea is ordered in advance. Companies usually order tea from those trees for many years in advance, and buy all the tea from an official in Guangdong or Beijing. It's all bought by one company, or by tea lovers, who are entrepreneurs and wealthy people. There are a lot of tea trees growing here. The farmer himself has about 20 of them. He shares the land with other locals, who own some of the other tea trees here. And I think even older ones that belong to other farmers. Let's try to find someone we can talk to. We figured out that Wenshen has an excellent red tea. So, here's another tree from the same tea garden. There's also many fruit trees. This tree is 300 years old. And the one I climbed is 800 years old. But I think it could be 1,000. Because it's very tall and very big in girth. This tree is pruned, so it grows out more branches. I tasted the tea from this tree and the smaller one, which is growing near the 1,000-year-old one. They were mixing the raw materials, and I didn't like it, even though it was harvested and processed by the same person. The tea is completely different. Today, we tried 6 types of Danzhou cha. I liked it the most. And I hope you like it as well. We'll only have 1 kilogram of it, so be quick if you want to try it. Here we can see what happens to the trees when the peasants have no idea what to do with them. Gushu used to be very cheap, so they just pruned the tree, and it grew more small branches, so they could harvest more. I think it happened not so long ago. Unfortunately, I saw a lot of the same example, where tea costs almost nothing, and people decide to clip the tree so it's more convenient to harvest. And the other is the demand for tea. Pruning it increases the harvest. I remember recently when we crossed Guangxi border and arrived at Xishan factory. They gave us this huge document that the Yunnan government issued about tea farming priorities. The protection of old tea trees was the first priority. So I think now it's illegal to cut them. I hope no one else will do this. Now we're at a micro farm. We've decided to try their sheng. We haven't had sheng for a long time. And I definitely need to drink more. We met another farmer, He's a bit older than the previous one. He produces sheng. Let's try his sheng. By the way, I learned something about Kao Cha production. To make true Kao Cha, you should roast it for a very, very, very long time to get a powerful taste. We won't start with Kao Cha. Let's try the usual sheng first. I think it's nice, but nothing special. Very ordinary. Especially if you compare it to the cheaper ones in Linsang. Now let's try his Kao Cha. I remember making Kao Cha in Jinggu. We'll try to ask the same old man that made it for us before. It's made in a wok, on a fire.
О, копченинки очень неплохо.
Ну что, так чай. Nice tea. Но почему-то тоже не вызывает восторг. Not bad at all. But somehow I don't know about the prices. But it has a weak aftertaste. And the price is not comfortable at all. Let's try his Danzhou Cha. Unfortunately, we didn't like the tea here. The people here are very kind, but the tea is not that good, sadly. We've arrived in another village. Here we have the traditional Yunnan tea, Kao Cha. It's being made in a traditional Turkish pot. The tea is constantly being brewed in boiling water. Real traditional cuisine. Everything is smoked. I've been to similar places several times. They've treated us with a cake. Very simple, very delicious. All food is delicious when it's cooked over a fire. This tea is great. Delicious. Yes, very delicious. But I think it's at its best when it's roasted. The very first guy told us that he can't see the difference between sheng. It's very delicious when roasted. But otherwise it's just usual sheng. They're going to bring us some Lao Cha. Let's try it and see how it tastes. I think Lao Cha should be boiled so you can feel its taste. Let's see what we have here.
Цвет пошел. Не, вкус слабый.
Weak taste. But still interesting. I wonder if the fact is that it's really natural fermentation in the bag. I think they've had this bag of sheng for more than 10 years. Oh, mysterious. Turned out that they have some Lao Cha. The youngest is not that good. But the second one is very nice. But this bag is the most interesting one. Its color is dark brown because it was lying above the kitchen on the roof. And the bag in general has fallen apart in some places. Waiting for the water to boil so we can try this tea out. I think this tea is 10 years old. The bag has a plastic lining inside it. So although it looks very bad, the tea will be preserved inside. Very strong aroma. I love it. It's unique. Even though my individual predilection is made. The water's ready. Let's try out this Lao Cha. It's saturated with essential oil. It's typical for an aged Sheng to have such aroma and taste. After lying for more than 10 years, that's the ticket. I think we'll buy the whole bag. It's a smoky bag falling apart. But I think that it will be ours forever. Cosmic tea. But it's better to put the tea in a new bag, because this one's about to fall apart. We're sorting out the rubbish, taking out the stalks and twigs, putting it into a new bag, because the old bag looked like pieces of a bear. We're just cleaning it up, taking out the garbage. They said that there's still another bag that the guys want to find as well. Let's surprise us with another bag. It looks like another super old Sheng. 15 years old or so. I think that we're in a village where nobody knows that Lao Cha has a big value. I'd say a huge value, because it's a very rare product that you usually won't find. To be found by a pirate in the south, where everyone understands everything already. That's why they keep it so irresponsibly in this dirty bag. Powerful tea. The first one was the best. But this one is nice as well. The color of the liquor is generally dark, just oil, and the balsamic aroma from this product. I remember an old photo of me with a guy who sold me the tea. He was very sad because he didn't want to sell it. I was happy because I had a bag full of Jinggu Lao Cha. I have another bag from Jingmai, but that one's hidden. I think I won't sell it because it's a treasure. The value of this tea is so high because it comes from very old trees. I'm as happy as an elephant. Today's a good day. The Yunnan journey was justified. Although we still have several days to spend here. We thought that seeing as we're in Wenshan, and we haven't been here for a long time, because it's a remote region in comparison to other tea provinces. Here's our Bao Bei, our treasure. Old tea, really old tea. We accidentally found it. Because you can spend 2 or 3 days visiting villages, looking for an old tea. And in 99.9% of cases, this tea is very expensive, or they simply don't have it. That's why today is a very lucky day. We have several bags of very old tea, One of them is 20 years old. You saw the bag's condition, so you can tell it's old. However, the tea is fine. Thanks to the cellophane packaging. Thank you, modern technology. I took a photograph of the package itself to see if I could find the year of production. One way or another, we have a great tea. Anyway, we got an excellent tea. But we won't sell it. It'll be on degustations instead. I personally love degustations. And I hope that you like them as well. I organise tastings regularly. More often in our Moscow and St. Petersburg clubs. But I try to visit all of them. I always try to surprise people during tastings. This tea is very rare, so it's only for very special occasions. Aged Sheng is a treasure. We've been driving for several hours already, and we'll drive a few more for our destination. We'll go to the nearest settlement, where there's at least something like a hotel. In addition, we punctured the wheel, and now we're driving with a flat tire. It's a risky business, but I think we'll be fine. If you can endure risks, try moving with us to get to the right place. I hope we get there in time. Today we'll spend the night in a hotel, and tomorrow we'll drive to another village. Yunnan roads are very long, so you can spend a lot of time in driving. Our journey is long, but still we don't have time to visit every place we want. We'll skip a couple of places. In Hunan and Jinji. Now we'll have a new travelling format. Before, we drove only through regions. But now we travel through several provinces. Something interesting always happens to us in Yunnan. Here, it's very often a story. Police often stop you to see if you're carrying any drugs, etc. You can go through 23 control points in one day, and you arouse suspicion if there's loads of suitcases. They look through anything you have in your car if you look suspicious. And they want to see what are inside the cases, and whether you're lying or not to them. They're looking for drugs from the Golden Triangle, because in Laos, in the north of Burma and Myanmar, people cultivate a lot of drugs. This traffic goes through China, therefore it's heavily controlled, with varying degrees of success. So there's a lot of checkpoints. Foreigners are being checked more often. And also, we don't have our passports at the moment. We forgot our passports in the hotel we were in yesterday. Because we got up very early. And the receptionist forgot to give them back. Today we've been driving all day without passports. It's a good thing I had photos of our passports when we arrived at the post. Luckily, I speak Chinese. They're asking, what do we have in the bags? I said, tea. Tea? They talked to us for about an hour and a half, and then they let us go. They told us to get our passports back from the hotel and bring them back today or tomorrow. They also took a picture of us, wrote down where we're from, and what's our destination. Now we're driving back. And our driver is very tired because he's been behind the wheel since the morning. So yeah, that's the story. I'm wondering if they'd give us a free night to stay. But it's our fault that we forgot the passports. I had a lot of confrontation with the police. Some stories I cannot talk about. For example, when I was captured near a military base. Everything ended up well here. Chinese policemen, on the whole, are very polite, with the utmost professionalism. They even apologized to us. Sorry that we, as it were, had to go back to get the passports from the hotel. Right now, we need to return to the hotel. I hope the receptionist didn't lose our passports. I'm sure everything will be fine. Dinner time. Today was a very long day. Plus, we were fixing the tire for 30 minutes. I'd like to tell you about food safety grade notifications. They have it literally everywhere in China. Even in the villages. Right now, we're in a restaurant with an A grade. Fedor, who's holding the camera, noticed that such restaurants don't have flies in them. B-grade restaurants have this issue. And C are horrible. We were in all of them. But I personally was in an A restaurant a long time ago. It's usually a B or a C. So we're hoping for a great dinner, worthy of the A grade. Enjoy your tea.